Now, I don't mean to brag, but the internet connection at my place is pretty good. Just like that, I'm downloading another Friends episode. I mean, another Nature paper. But we're so used to quick connections that we get frustrated when streaming isn't instant, or it takes ages to refresh the page. Imagine how frustrating it would be if the buffering speed of your brain was impaired. Not being able to process things quickly, feel, move properly. This is the reality for someone with multiple sclerosis. Just like an internet connection, our brains are made up of wires and connections too. Like a copper wire, the cables in our brain also have insulation wrapped around them in the form of myelin. And it's myelin that determines our brain's broadband speed. With it, messages can be carried up to 100 times faster compared to a cable with no insulation. So it can make a big difference if a myelin gets damaged. Multiple sclerosis is the leading cause of acquired disability in young adults. In Scotland, we've amongst the highest prevalence for the disease worldwide. In MS, the body's immune system goes rogue and attacks the myelin and the cells that make it, leading to compromised signaling speeds and even neuronal death. This damage can be repaired by laying down new insulation onto the exposed cables. But in MS, ultimately this process fails, and there are no treatments available to promote remyelination. What's needed is a model system to study myelin formation and translate those studies into effective promyelinating therapeutics. I'm using human stem cells, the building blocks of life that, given the right ingredients, can be made into any cell in the body. We can make neurons and the cells that make myelin, called oligodendrocytes. But no matter how these cells have been sandwiched together in the past, nobody has been able to generate proper human myelin in a dish. During my PhD, I've developed a brand new model of myelination, where human stem cells are grown as 3D spheres, tiny bundles of different cells that are grown for several months in order to mimic the development of the human brain. In this 3D environment, oligodendrocytes interact with neurons in a functional way. They grab hold of and tightly coil around the cables to form real myelin. It means that for the first time, we can ask whether certain drugs promote myelin formation in a human system. This will aid the expensive and inefficient process of drug discovery, help bring an MS therapy closer to the clinic, and bring superfast broadband back to MS patients. Thank you.